yesterday.
Working in an architecture project for my school using Revit, I found this awesome brick component for a section detail that stretch automatically by adding bricks like so. So I wonder whether this could be achieved in AutoCAD or not. So I'm gonna do a very special thing for my first YouTube member. Anyway, last week we talked about some of the first steps in starting AutoCAD. So today, let's save some time creating this dynamic block. So to start, I'm gonna draw some guidelines using the regular line command, like so. And I'm gonna offset it about 3/8 of an inch, because that's the standard size for the brick mortar. So I'm gonna offset it down like so. And then I'm gonna copy this down from this point. And I'm gonna use the array option. And I'm gonna say 4 items. And then I'm gonna pick the fit option. So once I have it like that, I know that 3 bricks, it's equal to 8 inches, which is the size of a CMU block. So I could type 8 inches here, and then finally press enter to exit that. So now if I remove this line that I don't need it, and just to double check, I dimension from here to here, and it is about 8 inches. Great. So now, of course, the brick size, the standard one is about 2 inches and a quarter. So the next step is to draw the vertical guidelines. So for the brick, the size for a standard brick is about, let me see over here. I'm looking at the website for brick. It's about 3 5/8. So that's where I'm gonna offset 3 5/8. So once I do that, I'll have the exact size to create 3 bricks that will be equal to 8 inches. So now at this point, I can simply use the rectangle command to create my first brick, like so. And then I'm gonna use the hatch command to hatch, to represent the brick in a section detail. And then I'm gonna change the scale to 10 and apply the hatch. Let's change it to about 5. So I'm gonna apply it, make sure associated hatch is selected. This means whenever you move or stretch the polyline, the hatch will also adjust automatically. So let me undo that. So once we have our first brick, let me first place them in the correct layers. So let me see what layers I have here. Okay, so I'm gonna create a couple of layers really quick using the layer command or the layer shortcut. And I'm gonna say N for new. And then I'm gonna create a layer called detail thing, press enter, So I can select this hatch and place my hatch on the correct layer. So now I can simply change the color by clicking here. And this color 211 is based on my plot style. So that's why I'm picking it. But of course, you can pick the color that you desire. So now make sure this polyline for the brick, it's on color by block. And so the reason is because we can easily change colors later when we create this or when we make it a block. So make sure it's on layer 0 and everything looks correct. So at this point, I'm going to copy one of these bricks up like so. And then using the arc command, I'm going to simply finish this like so, and then mirror it using the mirror command. Click here and then here and say no. So once I have my bricks, what I'm going to do is I'm going to select them and simply use the B shortcut to create a block and press enter. So at this point, I'm going to name my new brick section. I'm going to call it dynamic brick section. I'm going to name it lazy brick section. You can name it whatever you want. So make sure the base point on the screen is checked. And let's click OK. So a convenient point or base point for this brick dynamic block would be over here. So click. All right. So now that we have our brick, let's open it by right click on it and click block editor. So at this point, what we need to do is make this static block into a dynamic block, similar to the Revit, where it will add more bricks by simply stretching it up or down. So in order to do this, let's open the block authoring palette. If you don't see it over here, would be on the block editor and simply click authoring palette. So the first thing that we need to add is a parameter. So let's go to the parameter tab and I'm going to add a linear parameter. So I'm going to click here and then following instructions on the command line, I'm going to start with specifying a point here. And then finally over here. So I'm gonna click here and then I'll have this linear parameter. So I'm gonna select it and go into my properties palette. What I'm gonna do first is name this linear parameter so it's everything would be organized. So the name is over here. I'm gonna call it something like course height or press enter. And then what we're gonna do also here in the same property palette is to check the distance type to increment and then the distance increment. Here we need to specify the distance that we're gonna array, but first, before changing any of these settings so we don't get confused, I'm gonna leave it like that and we're gonna explain you later. first we're going to add, I forgot that we need to remove one of these arrows or pointers over here. They are called grips. So let's remove one of those grips to one, because we don't need the other one. So at this point, this exclamation mark is telling you that, hey, there is a parameter here, but it needs an action in order to work. So let's go to the action here, and we're going to use the array action. So if you click on it and follow the instruction, it says select parameter. So we're going to select this one, click, and then select the objects. Now the objects would be all of these ones. So make sure you select also the arcs, but not the bottom brick. So I'm going to select like so, and then press enter. Now it says enter the distance between the columns. So the distance would be from here, from this point, to this first brick. So since I don't know that distance, I'm going to simply click two times. One would be here, and then the second one would be here. So that will give AutoCAD the distance for the array. So since we did a lot, a good practice is always to test your dynamic block to see if it has any errors. So I'm gonna test this block by clicking in here. And then let's see how this block is working. Okay, we can see that it's working nicely. However, I saw one problem, which is that the stretch grip is not following or is not ending in the correct location. So let's quickly fix that. Let me close the block editor. And now let's select this parameter and go back to the property palette. At this point, the distance type is increment, so that's correct. But the distance increment right now is at zero, which is not right. The distance increment have to be the same distance that we previously picked for the array, which is from this point to this other point. So since we don't know that distance, you could simply use the dimension command to get it. But let me show you a faster way. And it is selecting again the parameter, going to the distance increment, and select this calculator over here. Once you do that, you have different options over here. And the option that we need is the distance between two points. So once we click that, we can click here, the first point, and then our second point would be here. Again, this is the correct distance. Once we click apply and go back to the properties, that's the correct distance. The distance minimum would be the height of these two bricks. So again, using the same procedure, using the calculator, and picking my first and my second point, like so. So once we do that, everything looks correct. Let me quickly do a test, and let's see how this brick wall section is working. As you can see, now the grip moves perfectly and nicely with the lazy brick wall section. So at this point, we can close this test editor and simply save the changes to the block and then remove all of the guidelines.
Hey, I'm Irving from the Lazy Arquitecto. Here is another blog thanks to my Patreon supporters, and subscribe for more AutoCAD blogs.